Oh, of course. Both sides are planning for war. I mean, neither side, I'm not sure, China for sure doesn't wish it, because it's getting stronger anyway. But in the US, yes, there are people who think that war is inevitable, sooner or later. And if it's inevitable, better to have it earlier than later, when China is not as strong. I think on the US side, there were many players. And if Biden were a stronger leader, he would have asserted leadership and that visit would not have happened. He could have called up Nancy Pelosi, and that would have stopped the visit. Xi Jinping appealed to him to stop that visit. In the end, he shrugged his shoulder and said, no, it's a separate branch of government. You may be a separate branch of government, but Nancy Pelosi was told, the Indo-Pacific Command cannot assure your security and is unable to make for a safe passage. But the visit would be off. But it was very carefully planned. So we don't know what Biden knew, but there are obviously people in the system who wanted the visit to happen. Whether it is just to poke China, or whether it is to bait China into a strong reaction. But I think that there was more than one agenda at play. We've been in a very tight position. I mean, to begin with, we have a special relationship with Taiwan. We have people there. So I think if I were in MINDEF, I'll be having contingency planning. Then, militarily, we have US ships and airplanes here. Do we allow them to make use of Singapore? There are a lot of speculations why Nancy Pelosi did not fly to Taiwan from Singapore, that she went through KL. Mm. Yeah. So I have no doubt, I'm not in government, but I have no doubts that we have a lot of people spending a lot of time thinking about this and worrying about this. I think at the top, both sides know that a war between them will be cataclysmic for the entire world, not just for the two countries. Right now, I think Rand has done these studies that if you have a war early, China will be badly bloodied, US will be hurt. 10 years from now, both sides will be bloodied. Maybe 30 years from now, well, not so sure. I read this study from Rand some years ago. I'm just paraphrasing in the loose way. But the point is, the longer you wait, the greater China's relative strength is. And those who are making these calculations know that. But China has got to signal that its nature is not that of a tiger. Its nature is that of a panda. I visited our pandas in Chengdu before they came back. Both of them, they were in separate cages. As I was approaching the bus, the keeper said, no, don't go too near. We can scratch you. I said, oh, I kept a healthy distance. It may look cute as a panda, but you don't fool around with a panda, you know. You can be badly mauled. So China is like that. It has its nature, but it's got claws. So please respect those claws. But it's not going to leap at you and eat you up. Because it's not in China's nature, which is why I wrote the chapter on China's homogeneity.